Good evening, everyone. I just want to give you a brief rundown of how to download and flash a BIOS on an RDNA 1 graphics card in Hive OS. Reasons why you may want to do this would be a graphics card you bought secondhand and that doesn't have the correct BIOS on it, showing up incorrectly, the memory is showing up as unknown, or you want to try to modify power limits and memory timings. So what you want to do is come to your rig, go to the overclocking tab, hit download vBIOS, and I'm going to select my 5700 XT. If you toggle this, it will also save a copy of this vBIOS into your Hive OS. I don't actually recommend doing that, so we're going to go ahead and hit download. Now what the rig is doing is it's issuing a command with AMD's vBIOS tools in Linux to stop the miner and to pull the BIOS out of the card. Once it's done that, this will show up white and it will download in your web browser to your local machine. In the instance your card is so badly working, and it's, well, not working, saying unknown and it won't start mining, what I would recommend then doing potentially is going over to a site like Tech PowerUp. They have a huge VGA BIOS collection, and you can usually search it pretty effectively. Here we have a Power Color 5700 XT dual fan. This is also called a fighter, but if you scroll to the bottom of the page, there is a download button. So we can go ahead and download that vBIOS if we really want to. Let me move the display so you can see it here. So it's downloaded a ROM file. What we could do at that point is come back over into our rig, go to overclocking, we could hit flash BIOS, and then what we would do under vBIOS ROM file is load up the Tech PowerUp downloaded BIOS that we just had. So you would load it from your downloads, which you can't see unfortunately, but I'm doing there. Once you've clicked OK, it will preload in here. Then you select which card you want to flash it to, and then you hit upload. You can hit force flashing if you would like. If your card is already not working, go ahead and hit that too. Hit upload, it will then stop the miner again, flash the BIOS, you can reboot your rig in Hive OS, and all should be well. You may have to try a few BIOSes to hit the exact same card. The thing is, you have to know the memory vendor. Unfortunately, not always is that listed in here. Typically it is. So it shows Samsung memory timings and Micron, but the BIOS file says Samsung. So again, you may have to try a few vBIOSes. If you have another identical card in your rig that is working correctly, you can always download the vBIOS of that card by coming into the download and selecting your other card. Once you've downloaded that vBIOS, you can flash it onto your primary card. So these are just a few suggestions and things I've learned from flashing a lot of Navi 10 BIOSes in my day. I don't actually recommend doing it on Hive if your card is working correctly, unless you're mining things like Ethash. So, anyway, hopefully that was a helpful little tidbit. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.